This week, the biometric tech helping Syrian refugees in Jordan. This week marks the fifth year since the conflict in Syria began. Since then, the region has seen a mass movement of people, as an estimated 4 million refugees have fled into neighbouring countries, including Lebanon, Turkey and Jordan. Distributing aid and processing papers for the refugees can be complicated and means that many people can wait at the border for a long time before they're let in. But for refugees entering Jordan, new ways of using biometric technology to identify people could make for quicker processing times and even easy access to aid through banks. And there's plenty of other inventive tech ideas to improve daily life coming from the refugees themselves. Jane Copestake has been to Jordan's capital, Amman, and the Za'atari camp near the Syrian border. Wahid Mustafa
al-Masri. Keeping in touch with family back home is critical for those whose lives have been torn apart by the conflict. The majority of Syrian refugees in Jordan live in the country's capital, Amman, where at least 600,000 have registered with the UNHCR.
So this is the waiting area for refugees. This is where they wait until they process their cases, whether it's interviews to renew the asylum seeker certificates or to follow up on their cases on an individual basis, whether it's for cash assistance, for health assistance, legal assistance. Whatever they may need, we have it here at UNHCR to offer.
And it's a lot of people in the room at the moment.
We have around 3,000 to 4,000 individuals per day.
Per day.
And this is why the registration center in Khalda in Amman is the largest in the Middle East.
Mahmoud Abdel Ghani. Mahmoud Abdel Ghani.
So we process their cases on a daily basis, whether it's registration, other units, or even resettlement interviews.
The problem of registering so many new people has led to a solution using advanced biometric technology. All refugees who enter Jordan have their irises scanned to confirm their identities and are given an identification card from the government. The process is two-step, with initial enrollment and annual verification. Today we meet a family from Homs who are renewing their asylum documents. The iris scan is considered the most secure form of biometrics. Fingerprints can change over time, especially for young children. Along with identification cards, the data is shared with local partners to try and make life a bit more normal. Bank accounts are automatically created with the Cairo Amman Bank, where aid money can be taken out in the blink of an eye. There is no need to register information again with the bank, as it comes through the UNHCR's secure iCloud server based in Amman. The data is also shared between four countries, Egypt, Jordan, Lebanon and Iraq, to ensure people aren't registered in two countries at the same time.